Grouped broadly, there are two types of backlight failures, mainly the mechanical failures and electrical backlight failures. Hello there, I am Dominic and these are the types of LED backlight failures that I have personally fixed. At the end of this video, I will explain the difference between a black screen and a blank screen. I have seen the confusion between the two happen a lot. Let us start with the electrical failures. You should also know that sometimes the mechanical failures can occur concurrently with electrical failures. I will start from the most common problem and gradually go down to lesser known problems. Number 1. Total LED failure, where all LEDs do not turn on. This can be as a result of one LED or more failing and thus creating an open circuit. This is what happened to this TV. You can see the lights work well when I bypass the damaged LED. Sometimes this problem can manifest as a very dimly lit TV. Watching this TV can only occur in a very dark room. Daylight and living room lights will overpower the light coming from the screen, making it appear even darker. Number 2. Dark spots on the screen. This is caused by partial failure where some of the LEDs are off completely while others are working normally. This happens when a damaged LED still conducts electricity although it does not light up. The opposite of dark spots is bright areas. I will cover this in the mechanical backlight problems. Number 3. Half bright screen. This occurs in edge lit TVs where half of the LEDs fail on one side. This causes the screen to be bright on one side while the opposite side has a dark area. This can happen from the left to right or top to bottom depending on the location of the LEDs. This is what caused the problem in this TV. Even the acrylic sheet is burnt. Number 4. Blinking lights. The most annoying problem of all. I call this problem, see me if you can. Number 5. Okay and gone. The TV lights up normally, then the backlight goes off completely after a few minutes or seconds. Just like that. Number 6. Okay, gone, and okay again. The LEDs turn off after some time, and if the TV is switched off and on again, the LEDs work perfectly again. That's the most difficult problem to detect as a technician. Some TVs can work up to 5 hours perfectly, for example. As a technician, can you sit for that much time watching TV trying to figure out the problem? Number 7. Power problem. Backlight problem caused by power supply failure instead of LED failure. The power supply as well as the LED strips will need to be replaced in this case. Number 8. The blue screen. The rarest type of backlight failure is when the LEDs emit blue instead of white light. You have to see this problem to believe it. For these 8 problems, I recommend changing the backlight with a complete set of new lights. A mechanical backlight failure occurs when the LED strips move out of its place or when the lens on top of the LED falls down. Number 9. Bright spots. This occurs when the lens falls down from the LED strip. The televisions I have seen with this problem usually come from the coastal areas where there is hot climate. Sometimes you will even see the lens at the bottom of the screen. They will also move and make sounds when you move the TV. Number 10. Bleeding light. This type of failure occurs in edge-lit backlit TVs when the strip moves out of place and so light from the backlit strip is not scattered evenly. The last type of mechanical failure I have seen is heat damage. This is when the failing LEDs produce so much heat that it burns the light scattering assembly. The result is a mess of deformed paper and soot. Normally, you will smell smoke but not see it. This problem usually occurs together with number 4. What happens is that as the TV warms up, the electrical connection is lost. Switching the TV off cools the connectors and they engage the connection again. That is why the TV will work again after you switch it on. Sometimes the connection works long enough to cause problem number 5. Now regarding the second problem above, dark spots, I have created a short video to help you diagnose if your LED TV has dark spots. My fourth backlight repair process video will guide you more on this problem. That said, it is very easy to diagnose a bright spot but not a dark spot. Blank screen versus black screen. This television has what is known as a blank screen. This means that there is no information on the screen. This is not a backlight issue since the backlight is working fine. A peek at the back of this TV will reveal some white light. This is an LCD screen issue and not a backlight issue. Now, total backlight failure is sometimes referred to as a black screen, the same first problem I discussed at the beginning. That is the difference between a blank screen and a black screen. I hope you learned something new today. For a better understanding, don't forget to watch the rest of the videos in the backlight repair process playlist. Thank you for watching and goodbye.